everyone. This is Destiny Davis here. This is for my potential flippers. So, I have a bunch of money and I want to invest. I want to invest in real estate. I've been watching HGTV and all these DIY channels, and I decide that, you know what? I've got what it takes to flip. What do I do? So, like everything else, it's not as easy as it looks. If it was that easy, everybody would be doing it. So, flipping is a fantastic idea, and what you have to do is find the right market where the acquisition price of the home is still gonna be somewhat discounted, or at least fair market, and you really wanna do the numbers. So it's super important to figure out and then possibly even forecast, depending on how big you wanna get into. But let's just assume you were like wanting to do a mom and pop, like small flip. So this is your first flip. So this is assuming you know a lot about the market, you're well-informed buyer, you've maybe bought and sold numerous houses or whatever the situation is. The point is that you're comfortable. So you wanna make sure that the market that you're in, number one, that there's actually demand for the product that you're gonna provide. So if there's like a ton of inventory of remodeled homes, that might not be the right market. Maybe you need to go to another town. Maybe, you know, there's an up-and-coming neighborhood. Always a good idea to figure out where the up-and-coming neighborhoods are, because, you know, you can build something, or you can flip a home there and actually make a pretty decent profit because people are moving from whatever area into this new up-and-coming neighborhood. So, you know, obviously you want to make sure you have a good team. Just like any other business, you can only do so much by yourself, but you need to surround yourself with, you know, honest, hardworking people that you trust to do a good job for you. You know, the last thing you wanna do as a busy professional is micromanage everybody, so making sure you have a licensed contractor that you trust. You know, I know that there's all these horror stories, but you know what, there are a lot of really great contractors out there. So I know a couple of them. I actually have some investors that I work with that, you know, use the same contractors, and they just do more developing, but they're like the investors, you know, so they provide the money. So there are a lot of good contractors out there. You just wanna do your homework, you know? But if it's just, you know, like a pretty basic flip, nothing too structural, a big thing that a lot of flippers aren't aware of is either zoning or permit stuff. So if you do wanna start knocking down walls or adding square footage or doing all of these other things, you must get everything permitted. I cannot say this enough. It like drives me crazy. I get it. Anytime you deal with the city or whatever, it's a little time consuming. It does take a little bit more effort. It does take a little more money. But when you actually go to sell the home after you finish, you have to understand the buyer is gonna do their full due diligence. So they're gonna find out that X home isn't permitted. And guess what? When that home is financed, because 90% of homes are, the bank's gonna say, well, guess what? The appraiser came in and only said that the house was 1,500 square feet, but it was advertised here as 1,900 square feet. Well, you're not gonna get any credit for that additional square footage. So the bank, the appraiser, is gonna have a really tough time justifying that elevated price per square foot, because now all of a sudden you have $1 million that was for 1,900 square foot, and now you have $1 million that's for 1,500 square foot. Clearly, your price per square foot is gonna go through the roof. And if it doesn't make any sense for any of the other homes in the area, guess what? The buyer is gonna walk, because they're not gonna be able to get their loan, or even if they're paying cash, why would they wanna pay over market value if they had to? I mean, I get it if it's a multiple offer type of a situation, but generally speaking, you know, it's not a wise idea. So if you're gonna do a bigger job, just go through the city, make sure your T's are crossed, your I's are dotted, especially if it's your first one. You want to really do a good job, and it's like anything else. You're going to have to learn as you go, and you're going to learn a lot of things that you're like, man, I'm going to have to do that this way on my next flip, you know? So you'll get the hang of it as far as that goes, but the first time around and every time around, get the right permits for sure every time. So, you know, that's basically it. You want to make sure that you find a good home at a good price with a neighborhood where there's demand for that home, inventory is not too crazy, and then, you know, find a good contractor where you can work hand in hand with. Obviously, real estate investing is a really good idea. Lots of people do it. They've been doing it for a very long time. If you're smart, you know, it could be a really great way to invest your money. So you might, you know, again, you might want to talk to your financial advisor or something like that to make sure that you're comfortable enough to do something like that, but do your homework. I hope this was helpful to you. I really appreciate you tuning in to the vlog. If you have any feedback for me, if you have a question, email me, DM me on any of my platforms on social, visit my website, destinydavis.com. Thank you.